Hey, what's going on everyone? It's LuPo here with a anti-malware video. Everyone always asks me, how do you stay safe on the internet, LuPo? What are your best antivirus picks and what are your recommendations and safety concerns? Well, in the video right now, I'm displaying on screen right now, if you're infected, some things commonly are when you start your computer up, your desktop will take extremely long to load, and that's on a fresh install, or your passwords suddenly stop working, or your screen starts flashing, or you generally get too many errors. And if you start up msconfig, which is a Windows utility here on screen, which is what I'm showing you, if you have something like this in your startup tray where it says bot1 or explorer, if you have an extra explorer in there and that's on a startup, that means someone's infected you with their explorer and their bot. And if you ever see that in your startup, it's time to get proactive and get the viruses gone. And things like this, there's other things like rogue software where it tricks you into thinking that you're downloading a real antivirus, but it's really just something someone made to scam money out of you, and it does nothing but cause headaches and a nuisance. In this video today, I'll be covering how to protect yourself, how to stay smart, and what the best antivirus options are to choose from for free and to crack. Alright, let's get right into it. First off, I'm going to go off of the paid for, which you can easily get cracked over the internet, antivirus options. First off is BitDefender Total Security or Internet Security. Next up is Kaspersky, and after so is Avast. These are very good antivirus. The first one I'm going to evaluate for you guys today is BitDefender, which is on screen here right now, Internet Security 2011. This is what I've always used, and the reason why I like it is upon having a strong antivirus where it controls if anything goes on inside of your system, it has a really good firewall that comes with it. The network here, as you can see here, you can whether or not choose whether you want your computer to be stealth, remote, or a generic adapter, whether or not you're on a VPN, what kind of network you're on, whether it be a trusted allow all, home, office, or public. And it does have quite a big database. Signatures is over 7 million, and the next antivirus that compares to this only has a virus database of around 4 million. So BitDefender really comes in first place for virus signatures. And one of the things people do complain about BitDefender is if you're on an older PC, it does tend to use up some resources. It can slow you down. So that's why I'm putting these into categories. And the next antivirus is Kaspersky 2011. This is also a very good antivirus option. It also itself has a very good firewall, has a very strong database. This is also an out of US developed software. It's always constantly evolving, and it has a very, very good proactive protection system against guarding against hijacked sites, malicious links, and along with bad executables. Kaspersky would be my second choice if I didn't choose BitDefender, although it is very hard to crack, and you always have to get new serials for it. It is a very good antivirus choice. Next up here is Avast Internet Security 2011. This would be my second choice if Kaspersky wasn't already there. What I like about it is it has an auto-virtualized sandbox, which allows you to run maybe infected software or potentially harmful software in a virtualized environment, avoiding your computer from being infected. Along with that, it has some really good real-time shields for P2P, mail shields, and script behavior shields. Along that, with a pretty good firewall where you can select whether you're at home, whether you're at work, or in a public high-risk zone, example, a cafe. Along that, a very good scanner. It has options for potentially unwanted programs, which is PUP. It has full system scan, removable media scan, which is very good. And its virus database is pretty vast as well. It has around almost 3 million signatures, but there are signatures within signatures that may sound weird, so in total it may have a little more than 3 million. Another thing I like about the Avast is whether you visit an infected site, it will tell you in the bottom right corner, and you can rate sites whether or not they're good, what kind of sites they are, whether it poses a risk, and it has an auto-search feature letting you know whether or not the Avast community has flagged this site as potentially harmful for your computer. Okay, now moving on to free antivirus protection. This is very basic protection. It doesn't have a firewall. And maybe it might have a firewall, rarely does it. The first choice would be Malwarebytes. It has been always renowned to know that it has a great antivirus database for being free. The next would be Avira, and then after that would be Avast Internet Security for free. This doesn't have the firewall, but it does have quite a great database compared to the paid version. I like Malwarebytes because it has early detection of rogue software, has a free, always constantly antivirus database that's always updating, along with Avira, does the same, along with Avast. So those are my top three choices. Now, what to do if you're infected? Don't worry, it's very easy to keep your system clean, even if you are infected. What I would recommend, if you really want to go the extra milestone, is install BitDefender Internet Security 2011, along with Malwarebytes. Always have Malwarebytes. Even if you have a paid software, I always have Malwarebytes installed on my system. It's a very good idea to have it installed. Not only do you have the free protection, but you have a very, very good set of protection if you have a paid software and a free software. You always have the early protection of... So if you're infected, install Malwarebytes and install BitDefender, either that or Avast. Run a full system scan, both of them with their antivirus signatures updated. Now, there are people out there that are comfortably running a current antivirus right now, and this video is not really for you. This is for people that are looking into getting an antivirus for their computer, or if they're already infected. Now, for people watching this and they already got an antivirus, I'm sorry this video doesn't really pertain to you, but kind of late to say that. But if you're having trouble installing the actual antivirus, try putting it on a USB device, booting into safe mode. And to boot into safe mode, you restart your computer, hold down F8, and you'll be able to click safe mode and install it from there, and then run a scan from there, and you should be fine. It should detect any infections on your PC. Now, commonly asked questions. How do I know if I'm infected? Well, this is quite obvious. If you have someone if you've had someone on your computer and they've downloaded something and you're not sure of it, and your computer passwords are suddenly incorrect, you've received emails and items go missing on your desktop or your webcam randomly turns on, that is a good chance that you're infected. And what I'm displaying on screen right here is called a rat. When people have your computer infected, they are able to see everything you're doing, all the passwords you have, turn on your webcam without your consent, take screenshots of your desktop, download files off your desktop, delete it. And when you're infected, it's a very bad thing. And when you're infected, you need to know right away, that way you can get the bug out of your system. Now, another way to identify if you're infected is start up Windows Task Manager. You can click Control-Shift-Escape on your keyboard, or right-click the taskbar at the bottom and click Start Task Manager. An easy way to detect if you're infected is if you go through your processes and you see duplicates of something. Now, some processes may already be duplicated by your system, and that is perfectly fine. As you see here, I have CSRSS, and that's an essential system process, and that's fine. Stuff like that is fine if it's duplicated, but if you see like two or three explorers running, or if you have like two Win logons running, then that's a very serious security issue. And if you're unsure whether or not you're infected with that Win logon, this doesn't apply to Windows XP. This only applies to people with Windows Vista or 7. Right-click the process, click Open File Location. This will open its directory in which it's located in. Now, if it's Win logon or Explorer, it will be normally located in System 32 of your computer. If it's located anywhere else, then that means it's a high risk of infection, actively infected. Now, I see time after time people running no antivirus on their computer, and a month later they PM me saying, "Help me, I'm infected, I've been hacked, what I do?" And I always recommend that they install a strong antivirus. That way, when they do get re-control access on their accounts, that when they make new passwords, the person who has infected them cannot get their new password. And a little bad analogy here, well, not analogy, little tip of advice. Running around on the internet without any antivirus is generally a very bad idea. You're eventually going to get infected at some point during somehow when you do something. Even if you do trust people's downloads, there are things called fully undetectable items, which when you run them, any antivirus will not detect it. But there are some out there like BitDefender that have proactive protection that will ask for your consent on the firewall saying, do you want this to run? So that's pretty good. And like I said, guys, if you do trust downloads, there have been people on YouTube before I've seen here. I'm not going to name any names, but I have seen trusted partners on YouTube distribute infected software that they've created to people or their subscribers on purpose to try infect people to their advantage. And that's something I really, really, really don't like. And that's why I'm outputting this video, to help protect you guys and give some advice on what the best antivirus is. How to safeguard yourself. And another tip on safeguarding: if you're gonna visit a website and it looks fishy, just don't go to it. Never go to a site that you have to question yourself whether or not this looks safe or not. You know, that's just a general internet rule. And another thing, if you're not running any antivirus, there are websites out there that auto-infect you. And what I mean by this is, if you go to the site, it'll automatically download infected software to your computer without your consent, and there's nothing you can do unless you have a very good antivirus installed, like I've said. So again, I've gone over today the top paid for and top free antiviruses that I do recommend, and if you do not have any antivirus installed on your computer, I highly recommend that you do so. So that's my little video of today, guys, on helping safeguard your computer. Hope I've helped. I'd appreciate if you give the video a like, and a subscription would be highly appreciated. So until then, see you guys, and have a great day like usual.